for so many years, the principal of the school, that is Ms. S.V. Mala, did not have a room for herself. Every inch was converted into a classroom and we didn't have a room for the principal itself. But by God's grace, now this is the hot seat, the nerve center of all activities. It is from this place that the instructions for the entire school goes, and Sri Vishwavidyalaya is indeed blessed that we have a very sincere and very selfless person as the principal of the school. So as we come out of Principal Ma'am's room, we have this room where we have our meetings with people who visit the school. So come along, let us keep moving. Welcome, my dear friends, to the Knowledge Center, the staff room of Sri Vishwavidyalaya. Over the years, it has been our earnest desire that we should provide good facilities for teachers. And now, by Swami's grace, we have this wonderful staff room. Every teacher has a shelf allotted, like a lot of ideas, a lot of collaborations happen here. And this is a happy place for all the teachers. Having had a glimpse of the Knowledge Center, I think our next step is to see how knowledge is imparted. And in this context, we have to understand that education is not filling of a pail or a vessel, but it is lighting of the spark. In the sense, the child should be able to look around the world and think, why this is happening, how this has happened, and what is it that is happening in front of my eyes. So every learning should be propelled, should be initiated by curiosity and not compulsion. Only then this process of learning will culminate in creativity. To understand how education can be imparted effectively, it is very important that we understand how a child learns. There may be 100 students out there, but each of them learn in different ways. Let us take the case of a teacher teaching a concept. When she teaches, not all students in the class have understood. Probably a group have understood. Okay, suppose the teacher says, the distance between the convex lens and the object is u, and v is the distance between the image and the lens, and f is the focal length. There is a group that has understood. But there are some students who are thinking, oh my God, like what's happening here? These students need a step further. What is it? This complicated thing will become very simple for them if the teacher is able to demonstrate. Or in other words, if the children see it, it becomes very easy for them to understand. And it is here that the labs in a school come very handy. So come along, my dear friends, let us have a look at the spacious, clean and self-sufficient laboratories of Sri Vishwavidyalaya.
The distance between the light source and the lens is u, and the lens turn in the screen is v. Today we are going to see how to identify the basic radicals. See, this is lead nitrate. So it is white in color, isn't it? So when I add the reagent potassium iodide, I'm making a solution. Okay, I'm taking a solution of lead nitrate, and when I add potassium iodide, see the change, observe it. Okay, what a beautiful yellow color, isn't it? This is because of lead iodide.
The first group of students who understand everything when the teacher says are auditory learners. The second category, who understand when it is demonstrated to them, like when they see it, they understand. They are called as visual learners. And the third category is kinesthetic learners, who understand and never forget a concept if they are able to do it. So in this context, let us step into the computer lab and watch the students follow the instructions given by the teacher, try hands-on and learn. And I would like to convey something that all students from 3rd standard to 12th standard are brought to the lab, and that is how they learned computer science, not from a textbook or not from something put up on the board, but hands-on experience is given to each and every child, and the school has two complete well-furnished labs.
Good morning, students. So today we are going to see about the HTML program. HTML is nothing but hypertext markup language where we can design the web page for many projects, for many companies also.
But even as I was telling of all this, I realized that there are things that cannot be shown in the lab. For instance, if you have to take a lesson on the human heart, you can't show it in the lab, right? Or if you're going to talk about the lofty snow-clad Himalayas, again, it's not possible to show it in a classroom. And every child now is so adept to technology, even while elders are still groping and trying to find out how this mobile works, how this tab works, isn't it? So ideally, every child is a technological learner. And taking advantage of this, the school has utilized the Educom Smart Class services.
There are four chambers, two upper and two lower. The upper two chambers are called atria and the lower two are called ventricles.
So every classroom is a vibrant classroom, audio-visual area where children can watch lakhs of clips and videos which will enable them to understand the concepts and all that presented through technology which all of them love. So these are the different ways in which we reach out to the multifarious learners that could be there among the students. And yet, there are times when a group of students in every class are not able to cope up. It doesn't matter what we give, but there is some block or there is some problem in the mind of the child that he is not able to cope up with studies. So, do we have a plan for slow learners? Yes, definitely. Students who are slow learners, maybe 5 to 10 of them are there in every class, they are requested to stay back, and every day from 3:45 to 4:30, the class teachers stay back, and instead of handling the entire group, if the teacher is able to focus her attention on these 5 to 10 students, definitely their children will improve. And it is not just left randomly. There is a teacher in charge who makes a timetable and who monitors the progress of students who've been attending this remedial class. The next and the most important thing is preparing the child for the board exams, 10, 11 and 12th classes, isn't it? So the best preparation can come when the child is already exposed to a number of tests. So every month the school conducts 3 tests. So 3 into 10, that is 30 tests the child writes before writing the final board exam. This is not inclusive of the numerous objective tests that the child can attempt in the computer lab. So objective sessions are separate, and the theory exams, 30 exams the child writes before appearing for the board exams. And that could be one of the main reasons how the school has been consistently getting 100% results in board exams and many students getting very good marks and giving their best in the boards. Now, the entire school follows this formative test pattern, right? So this is a very nice methodology wherein the child writes 2 tests which are textbook oriented and 2 tests are creative ones. And in the end of every term, there is a summative test. So the formative tests are a combination of creative abilities and IQ tests. This makes the left and right brain of the child to flourish and nourish, and by the time he comes to 10, 11 and 12, his brain is fully developed. Whatever said and done, education or learning sometimes can be really boring for the child. So it is very important to introduce activities. Every Saturday is a no bag day. Just imagine the joy of the child. On Saturday, he just wakes up and thinks, today I don't have to carry my books or bag to the school, and it is a half a day. Children come from 3rd standard to 8th standard. They come to the school and try out different activities. 2 subjects per day, This Saturday, suppose they're working on science and maths, next week it will be like social and language. And in this format, a timetable is done. There are in charge teachers who take care of this, and children have fun every Saturday just doing the various activities. Though a lot of training and techniques are adopted by the school to impart knowledge, it is again the responsibility of the school to make the child understand that learning is also self-learning. Actually, when you step out of school and go to college, I think 90% of it is self-learned. So, the library, books in the library, the ambience in the library should motivate a child to learn things on his own. Now I would like to ask you all one question. Is all learning restricted to classroom? What about corridors? Are corridors just moving spaces? Dear friends, it is indeed a proud moment for me to share this wonderful news with one and all. The school was given an award in Prashanthi Nilayam for carrying out innovative practices and making corridors effective centers of learning. The concentric circles, the thematic notice boards, the award notice boards, the quiz boards, like this, there are a lot of things happening in the corridor that make the child stand for a moment, look along with his friends and enjoy this process of learning. And beyond this, it is the campus. The moment the child steps into the campus, the vibration of the campus is such that it makes him focus his mind on activities that are constructive and helpful for his life. Wherever he goes, there is music happening in one place. There are Vedam chanting happening. There is a practice session going on for assembly. So this motivates the child to engage himself also in all these multifarious activities. And hence, learning is not restricted to classroom or to corridor, but the whole campus resonates with this positive vibes that every child is molded towards a better future. The infrastructure can be there. The ideas can be there, but it will reach the child only through the channel of teachers. And at this juncture, it is really the blessings of Bhagwan that the teachers of Sri Vishwavidyalaya are not only experienced but also enterprising and enthusiastic to strain to any level so that the child gets the best of experience. This is an organization that is empowered by women. All the staff members are like mothers, lovingly and caringly reaching out to every child. But at the same time, you may have years of experience. Updating of knowledge is a very important component. Every academic year begins with a training program. And in this regard, we would like to express our gratitude to the Sri Satya Sai Educare program for introducing the concept of 21-day training session and the very vibrant experiential learning concept, and also to Sri Satya Sai Vidyavahini program for introducing the lovely 7-asset module and IIEP by 4C module, which have been very effective tools in upgrading the level of the curriculum. In today's episode, we have just covered the IQ of the child. There's a lot more. There is the EQ, there is the mental health, there is the physical health that has to be taken care. So we will watch all that in the upcoming episodes. If you like this content, give it a thumbs up. Share it with your family and friends. And finally, if you've not subscribed to the channel, please go ahead and subscribe. Stay tuned. Stay fine. Thank you. Jai Sairam.